beautiful service of hanging in the Grand King's Kid. We meet today at 5. Youth group will meet today at 5, and they will stay and participate in the 6 p.m. service, too. There will be services of Advent, Christmas carols today, tonight, at and December 17th at 6 p.m. Reason for that was last year we went all the way through and I heard people say, well, you know, we never seen my carol. We didn't sing one. So don't expect a lot of preaching, okay? We're going to get together and sing carols and just enjoy the beauty of this season. And if you'd like to play, sing, or play a special, please see Kathy Atkins. Please bring snacks. Please bring stickers to be served. In fellowship hall afterwards. I'm sorry, I misread that to start with. Looking forward to that service of carols tonight. Senior dinner will be Wednesday, December the 6th at 12. There are baskets in the narthex for monetary donations for the Christmas Eve fruit bags and pastor's Christmas. No men's Bible study or ladies' prayer group for the month of December. We're having New Salem Methodist again this year with Christmas gifts for needy children in the county on December 7th to go shopping at Walmart. Money and a list of needs will be provided. And anyone interested in going, let Senator McCabe know. And they'll meet at the Baptist Church and they'll wrap the gifts. And the Sheriff's Department will deliver those gifts. I really like the idea of working with the first responders agencies around the Sheriff's Department, the EMTs, and other people to do these things. That's a great thing to happen. Congregational meeting on Sunday, December 10th, 6 p.m. All church members, please attend this important meeting. Agenda memo was sent on December 1st. If you didn't get one or wish a printed one, tell Ruth and she'll get you one. People said, what is this congregational meeting? What this is in the Methodist Church, it was called Church Conference. And in your church, we're calling in a church meeting. And it will happen once yearly, and this is a place where any amendments to the bylaws, to our procedures are made. This is where your officers are elected, people who lead your church in the next year. So be sure to be here Sunday, December the 10th, 6 p.m. New Salem Mountain Christmas, December 16th at 6. And we have a family for the live nativity. If you're interested in helping with our church, but sign up sheet on the bulletin board. Class of church membership and baptism will be again on December 17th, 10:15 in the education building. And we're hoping that our baptism and membership Sunday will be January the 7th. Next man-up meeting will be January 6th. And if you have a prayer request or a joy, at least
offspring and in Bible saved.
All glory to God in the highest.
I still let it. We'll come up and we'll one more.
The Advent wreath is a vivid symbol of anticipation and preparation. The lighting of the new candle each 4 weeks before Christmas reminds us that something is happening, but more yet, something is to come. The circle of evergreens reminds us of everlasting covenant offered in the birth of Jesus. The four candles symbolize hope, peace, joy, and love. Today we light the first candle, symbol of Christ, our hope. May the light sent from God shine in the darkness to show us the way of salvation.
Yeah.
government will be upon your shoulder. And the nation will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
The nation signs ever means to be considered a symbol of eternity, a sign of God's everlasting nature. Isaiah tells us that there will be no end to the reign of the Messiah. Therefore, we hang wreaths shaped in circles and place garlands of green as a sign of everlasting life. These are symbols of God's gift of eternal life and the celebration of Christmas itself.
Thank you.
despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, but he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
For Christians, this passage from Isaiah reflects the suffering of Jesus, who saved us from our sins by his death on the cross, and by his resurrection from the dead. In ancient times, holy and idols were considered signs of Christ's passion. The purple leaves suggested the crown of thorns, the red cherry suggested the blood of the Savior, and the bitter bark is the drink that was offered to Jesus on the cross. As we place the holy and idol, let us remember the coming of Jesus our Savior. Joyous sense, color of the flower is blood red, reminding us of the male conflict killed by King Herod, going to eliminate any threat to his throne. We sometimes forget this part of the story, which made it necessary for Mary, Joseph, and the Christ child to flee to Egypt.
The center. Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
As our final preparation for the coming of Jesus, the light of the world, and the light that is not true. But before we light the tree, there's one more thing that needs to be produced. Some decorations still remain. I need to add to the tree. Jesus said, "Let the children come unto me." So if kids want to come up, just take the tree.
Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and before one another. Merciful God,
we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be obedient in church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors.
We sneaker. Thank you a bunch of people today. Thank you for your assistance for singing. Thank you, all you readers, people who bring the scripture to us on this beautiful, beautiful season. Thank you, Judy, for helping us sing as a congregation these beautiful carols and hymns. Lots to be thankful for. Beautiful season that we're in. Would you join me in the great thanksgiving? Page 13. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere. Give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering and death and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." So in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves, O Lord, in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Let them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Do you join with me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our heads are still bowed, and our minds are still focused on the Lord. We pray this morning for Julia Morgan. We pray for Ruth Key. We pray for Josh and Andrew's nephew.
First reading this morning is from 1 Corinthians 1, 3 through 9. May God our Father and Lord Jesus Christ give you all of his blessings and great peace of heart and mind. I can never stop thanking God for all the wonderful gifts he has given you now that you are Christ. He has enriched your whole life. He has helped you speak out for him and has given you a full understanding of the truth. What I told you Christ could do for you has happened. Now you have every grace and blessing. Every spiritual gift and power for doing his will are yours. During this time, we're waiting for the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he guarantees right up to the end that you will be counted free from all sin and guilt on that day when he returns.
Amen.
God will surely do this for you, for he always does just what he says. And he is the one who invited you into this wonderful friendship with his Son, even Christ our Lord. Please rise as we read the gospel. Mark 13, verses 24 to 37. After the tribulation ends, then the sun will grow dim and the moon will not shine, and the stars will fall. The heavens will convulse. Then all mankind will see me, the Messiah, coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And I will send out the angels to gather together my chosen ones from all over the world, from the farthest bounds of earth and heaven. Now here is a lesson from a fig tree. When its buds become tender and its leaves begin to sprout, you know that spring has come. And when you see these things happening that I described, you can be sure that my return is very near, that I am right at the door. Yes, these are the events that will signal the end of the age. Heaven and earth shall disappear, but my words stand forever. However, no one, not even the angels in heaven, nor I myself, knows the day or hour when these things will happen. Only the Father knows. And since you don't know when it will happen, stay alert, be on the watch for my return. My coming can be compared with that of a man who went on a trip to another country. He laid out his employees' work for them to do while he was gone and told the gatekeeper to watch for his return. Keep a sharp lookout, for you do not know when I will come, at evening, at midnight, early dawn, or late daybreak. Don't let me find you sleeping. Watch for my return. This is my message to you and to everyone else. The word of the Lord will be.
Thanks be to God.
On this first Sunday of Advent, God's business is the salvation of the world. And that's why God with us. The Lord, our righteousness, we said. Christ, our hope. The wonderful counselor, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the Messiah. The one who bore our infirmities and carried our diseases, Jesus, our Savior. The Son of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus, the true light, all these things. But the most powerful thing that was said today comes out of that passage from Mark. It says, then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Most powerful statement that we can think of to say. Jesus said it again, that same phrase. He said it in Matthew. But in Matthew, this is happening. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for false testimony against Jesus so they might put him to death. But they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. And at last, two came forward and said, this fellow said, I'm able to destroy the temple of God and build it in 3 days. The high priest stood up and said to Jesus, have you no answer to this? What is it that they testify against you? But Jesus was silent. Then the high priest said to Jesus, I put you under oath before the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God. Jesus said, you say so. But I say this. From now on you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven. Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, he's blasphemed. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your verdict? And the people said, the council said, he deserves death. And they spat in his face and they struck him, and some slapped him, saying, prophesy, you Messiah. Which one of us was it that struck you? There's something more than God our righteousness, something more than the Son of God, something more powerful than anything that has ever been called before. And you have to go all the way back to the book of Daniel to see it. Israel had always been looking for a national Messiah, somebody to come and save Israel. And that was one of the charges against Jesus, that he was claiming to be the Savior. given dominion and glory and kingship, that all peoples, all nations, and all languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not pass away, and his kingship is one that shall never be destroyed. Thank God, thank God, thank God. For what God is about to do in the second coming of Jesus Christ, for what God has already done in the first advent of Jesus Christ. Amen. Blood of our Lord poured out for you and for me for the remission of sins. Lord, we have asked your blessing upon these elements. We pray that you would let them be for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Son of God, the Lord, our righteousness, Emmanuel, Messiah, Son of Man, Word made flesh. Thank you. after the